Hey guys, welcome back. So I just created my first personal website, and in this video tutorial, I'll show you exactly how to use Google Sites and create your own website for free in just 10 minutes. So I want to start on my laptop and I'm going to sites.google.com. First thing first, in order to use Google Sites, we are going to need a Google account. So if you have an account, you're all set and you can get it started. So this is the new Google Sites homepage, and we are going to go to the plus button at the bottom right corner, and we have the option to create a new website from scratch, or we can select a pre-made template and start customizing the way we like. Now, creating a website is easy, but if it's your first time using Google Sites, I highly recommend choosing one of the pre-made templates because it makes everything easier for you. So Google Sites templates are divided into four different categories. We have personal, work, small business, and education. I'm gonna quickly show you the main template so you can decide which one works best for you. And next, I'll create a new website from scratch. So this template is called the portfolio, and with this template, you can tell about your work and yourself. Usually, a portfolio includes your accomplishment, projects, and it's useful when you want to show how your skills have improved over time. So this template is called the event, and as you can see, it has different pages, menus, and content about the speakers, the venue, and a reservation button at the end. Next, we have the small business, and there are five pre-made templates. So this one is the restaurant template, and it has the reservation option, location, chefs, and some other features. Now, every element you see here is customizable, like the background, colors, pages, and I'm gonna show you exactly how they work in a few moments. Finally, we have the education templates, and they are very useful for teachers and students. For example, this one is the student portfolio, and it's quite simple. You can add your name and picture and write about yourself, your goals, and achievements. So let's go ahead and create a new website from scratch. The first thing first I like to do after I create my website is to give it a title, because we might have different websites. So I'm gonna just go ahead and enter my name, Ali Rastegari, at the top left corner. Now notice when I do that, it changes the name down here as well. So if we don't want that here, we can simply remove or leave this space empty, or we can add a logo instead of that. So let's give it a try. We can click on add a logo and upload or select our logo here. Just to show you how it works, I'm gonna click on select and go to the Google image search and search for the logo. And as you can see, this is what it looks like when you upload your logo. If there is anyone else you're working with on this website, you can just go ahead and just like other Google documents, add more people by clicking on the share with others button. Simply enter their email, set the restrictions, and let them collaborate. Before we start adding more pages and content to our website, we can choose a theme. As you can see on the right side, we have three different options. We have the insert, where we can add content, we have pages, and we have themes. So once we click on themes, we can see there are different options. We have the simple theme, we can change the color from here as well. We have the Aristotle, Diplomat, Vision, Level, and Impression. We can also create a new theme by just clicking on the plus button, giving it a name, selecting a color palette, and selecting fonts for titles and body text. Finally, we can upload a theme as well by clicking on the import theme button. Personally, I use the Aristotle theme for my own website, so I'm just gonna select this one for this video. Now we can go ahead and start adding content, and we can always come back and change the theme later. So one of the first things we need to do after selecting a theme is to change our header image. Another way to find header images is by searching. For example, if an accountant wants to create a website, he can search accounting and select one of the images from the search result. Now, just as a bonus point, I'm gonna tell you guys what I'm gonna do here to just make our website a little bit more professional. So instead of selecting an image, I'm gonna upload a time-lapse GIF, because I think GIFs look much better than images, and my favorites are the time lapses. For example, this is the time lapse of my city, Vancouver, and it's what I selected as a header on my own website. You can search time lapse GIFs and select a nice animated header that's related to your business. For some people, like realtors, it could be your city. We can change the header type as well. So maybe it's the homepage and you want to cover all of it. So we can select cover, just like my own website, and make our header cover the full page. If you don't like that, you can always is select the large banner like this, or the banner and title only, which removes the image. So I'm gonna leave it as a cover, just like my own website. Now that we have our header, the next step is to go to the bottom of our page and add a footer to our website. So the footer is a horizontal block that goes under all of your pages. We can add all kinds of information here, like our menu, contact information, social media, and much more. Now, this is what my footer looks like. I added my name here, link to my homepage. You can add a logo if you want as well. I added my menu as well as my social media channels right here. There are other things you can add here, like collecting emails for the newsletter, or you can add your address, phone number, or email. If you want to change the background color, you can simply go here and add or select a color or image for your footer's background. Now, if you want to see what our website looks like on a phone screen or on a laptop screen, we can click on the preview button and take a look at how things are looking like on different screens. All right, now we are ready to add some content to our page. The first step is to update the title. You can add your name or business name or just leave it empty, but I prefer to put my name here. The next step is to add some content. So as you can see on the right side under inserts, you have the text box. So if you click on it, you can see we have a new block here that we can enter some content, and we can change the font, change the size, we can make it bold or insert a link, and we can simply remove it. Now we have the images, and we have the option to upload or select an image, and we can use the Google image search or simply upload an image. We can crop the photo, make it bigger or smaller, or we can insert a link. Another thing we can do is to insert an embedded form. So if you want to add any form to your website, like subscribing to a newsletter to collect email addresses from your audience, you can simply enter the embedded code from Google Forms. So we can simply copy the URL or embed code from here and insert it right into your Google Sites, and you're going to have a newsletter form on your Google site. As you can see on my website, I use Google Forms to collect email addresses and subscribe people to my monthly newsletter. Now, collecting email is something that you must be doing, and it's quite simple. You just go to the Google Forms and create a new form, and from there you can copy the URL and embed that code and insert it into your Google Sites, and you're going to have a newsletter form on your website. So if you want to add a new page to your website, you can just go to the pages and click on the plus button, and you're going to have the option to create a new page. You can simply name it. For example, we can name it Contact Us page and click on done and simply drag it onto your homepage. So most of the websites have a homepage that have a Contact Us page. If it's an e-commerce store, you can add a product page, and if you're a blogger, you can add a blog page. As you can see on my website, I have my home page, I have my courses on a separate page, I have consultation page where my audience can book a consultation with me, I have my YouTube page where I post my recent YouTube videos, and I have tools and contact page as well. So a lot of people, especially bloggers, use affiliate marketing as a side hustle. So whenever people click on this link and go to Amazon and shop it from Amazon, you're going to earn and a small percentage on their purchase as your affiliate marketing commission. So if that's the case, you can create a new page. For example, I called my affiliate page tools, and you can simply insert this content block here like this, and you can enter the picture of that product, you can insert the name, and here you can simply click on insert links and copy your URL link here. So when people click on that and go to Amazon and shop it, you're going to make a commission. So just to give you guys some idea for designing your own website, I'm gonna show you guys my own website. As you can see, I started with a cover which covers the first slide of my homepage. Next, I have my newsletter here where people can enter their email address and subscribe to my newsletter to get some exclusive content. Next, I have a small section for my YouTube channel. So if you don't have a YouTube channel or you have an Instagram page, you can simply replace the Instagram logo here and add your Instagram pictures and link them to your account. Next, I have my courses here. Next, I have my consultation block where people can book a consultation with me. And finally, this is my footer where I have my name, I have my menu right under it, and at the bottom right corner, I have my social media channels that I designed with Canva.com. The next page is the courses page where I have some information about my Amazon FBA course. So I entered two paragraphs here, but on the right side, I have a picture. And as you can see, I added a link to this picture. So when people click on that, they're going to get redirected to my Amazon FBA course. Now on the next page, as you can see, we have the consultation on the left side. I have the text block and I wrote a short text about consultation. And on the right side, I added a form and I made this form with Google Forms, which is another free tool as well. And I embedded the code here, which was super simple. Now the next page is my YouTube page where I post my last YouTube videos. If you don't have a YouTube channel, you can simply call this page a blog page and you can add your blogs. I call the next page tools, but in fact it's my affiliate marketing page. And as you can see, I have different offers and different tools that I use for my own business. And if people use these links, they are going to save at least 50% and I'm going to make a small commission on their purchase. Now the last page is the contact page where I added a contact form that I created with Google Forms, which I explained before. So as you can see, I created three different forms with Google Forms. I have my contact form, I have subscribe to my newsletter form, and I have a consultation form. So make sure to check out Google Forms as well. Finally, I want to show you guys the setting, starting off with the navigation. As you can see, we can choose our menu to be on the top or on the side, and you can choose the color of your menu. For example, here we have the black and white, but I personally like to leave it just transparent color. Next, we have the brand images. You can add a logo which goes to the top left corner of your website, and you can add a favicon, which is a small icon or logo which appears next to your URL on the browser you are using. For example, I created a simple favicon with canva.com. There are some other favicon generator websites which are free, so I use the blue background and I use A, and I uploaded my favicon here. Next, we have the viewer tools. The first one is the info icon, which shows your website, last updated time. I personally like to turn it off. And the next one is the anchor links, and anchor links appear next to the headings of your website, which is completely unnecessary, so I turn this one off as well. Next, we have the custom domains. As you can see, you have three different options. You can select a domain from Google Domains, you can use a domain from a third-party website like GoDaddy.com, and you can buy a domain which costs on average $15 a year. Next, we have the analytics section where we can connect this website to our Google Analytics account to get insight and metrics on our audience, which is a must. Finally, we have the announcement banner, which is displayed at the top of your website. So I'm just going to click on the show banner and change the banner red to color, and it's going to look like this. You can use it to collect email addresses or promote a new product. Now the final step is to publish your website. So if I click on publish, it's gonna give us a Google site web address, which is going to look like this. But as I mentioned before, if you want to add a custom domain with your own name, like my website alirastegari.com, you can buy a custom domain which costs only $15 a year. Next, we have who can view my site, which is anyone. If you click on manage, you can see that you're able to edit as well. So once you're ready, you can go ahead and click on publish and create your own website with Google Sites. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Now if you have any questions, make sure to comment below and I'll try my best to get back to you as soon as I can. If you found this video helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already, and make sure to watch one of these videos next. As always, thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Cheers.